Russians again took the lead in space. No? They were the first one ever. They built up Mir, the first the equivalent to a Skylab or the first generation ISS, a space station actually, wherein they could put only about three people could live in there. They would want to study how will humans survive in space. They are very much way, way advanced. They started in 1986, maximum capacity of three. It was during that time, from 1986 to 2001, it was one of the longest, one of the longest single space flight ever done. No? Okay, so it stayed in space for that long, 1986 to 2011. That was 15 years in space. And the longest person that ever stayed in outer space up to this day, nobody has broken that record, is a total of 437 days and 18 hours. 437 days and 18 hours in 1994 to 1995. His name was Valery Polyakov, another Russian. So this one proves that humans can live in outer space. Although when they come back to Earth, it's a completely different story. Okay. So moving on to the next slide. Now, in 1993, they decided to put, things started changing. The Cold War started becoming warmer. It did not become really, the war started to ease down. And people said, let's have not war, let's have peace, let's start showing a little, let's start moving towards collaboration to each other. So the first ISS was built, not exactly ISS, there was an agreement between the US and the Russians that they would say that to show our friendship and our mutual agreement for space exploration, why not we link two units, one from Russia, one from the US. And in space, that's what they did. They linked in the Mir-2 and the Freedom Project. They brought it together, and that was the beginning of the International Space Station. Since then, International Space Station, they have been adding module after module after module. All they tell the people that are building their modules is that for you to link it, it must have these specifications to lock in. That's all they have to do. I don't know how many modules are there right now, okay? But right now it's easiest to say that it is the largest structure in space. It is the longest standing rider. It already broke the record of Mir, okay? It is the longest structure to be inhabited in space. It's in 2010. It had that record already in 2010, so 1993 to 2010. It's now a research facility for biology, astronomy, physics, and meteorology, and so on and so forth. No? All these things. No? Of course, it's also a facility for some people to do R&R. No? I'll get to that later. No? So there's a new beginning. This is a new International Space Station. The world now wants to be mutually working together or working towards collaboration. Next. Now, when we think about it, when you stop to think about it, you ask yourself, what is the sustainability of a space program? No? The reality is this. A space program is something that deals cost. It doesn't bring in any profit inside. So every government that spends on it loses money. The only thing they gain is knowledge, research. But there is not much development or not much applications, okay? Maybe the applications other fields such as, for example, the development of the Velcro was something that was made for space use. Now it's being used for our application here, okay? Like the development of, these fluorescent lamps were also through here. No? There are technologies that trickle down. The use of material engineering developed because of a space program. Those developed, no? But there was no direct development nothing going back to the government because it would always be something that they would spend in. So in the last decade, since 2000, government priorities have changed already. Okay? USSR has collapsed, where it had several countries, which include Ukraine. I forgot the other name of the country, but Ukraine was one of them before. That was separated, and the USSR is just known as Russia. No? Okay. There was a time when US was in war in Middle East, so they had to divert most of their funds into war, rather into the space program. NASA had two major accidents wherein their shuttles blew up in space. The names of the shuttles were Challenger in 1986, and the other one is Columbia in 2003. No? That's why right now they had to retire almost all their space shuttles already. No? US has no space shuttles right now. No? The last one that flew was back in 2013. No? Okay, so it is costly to fund a launch. On the average, think about this. It would cost you $20,000 per kilogram just to send one thing to the moon. $20,000 per kilogram. Just to send something to the moon. That includes your payload and everything. Okay? So it's really, really costly. Okay? Next.